For Marina Prior is returning to the award-winning musical Mary Poppins, proving once again she's practically perfect. Please welcome the one and only Marina Prior. It's really hard not to sing along. I just wanted to start going yum diddly diddly yum diddly.
Oh, you know, even know the yum diddly diddly yum diddly I bit. That's fantastic.
You know the lyrics,
Pricey.
No, that's it. Marina, we saw you there in 2011 playing Mrs. Banks. Now you're coming back yet again to play the eeny meeny babysitter that no one likes.
That's
Do you like her character?
Oh, look, I relish the chance to play a villain. You know, they're always really fun to play. And I spent a lot of my early career playing extremely nice girls because I was sort of young and pretty and I had a high voice. That's how you get cast. But as the years have gone on, I've really enjoyed playing sassy characters and comedic characters and things that really kind of push your boundaries. And so, yes, Miss Andrew is really nasty. She's sort of like the witch from Wizard of Oz. She's very unpleasant.
We can't wait to see you as Miss Andrew in person. But what was it about this musical and the storyline in particular that made you come back for more?
Well, you know, as you can see from the footage, it's incredibly spectacular and just magnificent skill sets seen there in the dancing, the staging, you know, all of the characterisation, all of that is just beautiful. But I think what ambushes the audience in Mary Poppins is actually at the heart of it, it's just the story of a family, a mum, a dad and two kids that are fractured and not connecting, particularly the dad. He's very distant and Mary Poppins, this magical nanny, comes in and actually puts the family back together. And it's that emotion in the story that I think really grabs people. A lot of people might go along thinking it's just for their kids that they're taking, but it's actually an adult ticket as well, which is really smart.
You mentioned you're up for a challenge. You're taking on two roles.
I am.
What? How?
Well, so I am playing the nasty nanny, Miss Andrew, but I'm also playing the really, I think she's sort of like a homeless lady, but who's really an angel. That's the bird woman who sings the beautiful Feed the Birds. So she's the antithesis of Miss Andrews. She's like a little angel, like this beautiful homeless.
So your average character is a nice enough person.
Exactly. I'm somewhere.
Yeah.
I'm averaging out to be okay, I think. But so it's going to be, it'll be a real challenge to play such completely different people in one show.
Obviously you're a legend of the stage, but I did not know that you started out busking on Bourke Street in Melbourne.
Well, I did.
What a story. What was in your set list?
Believe it or not, it was very eclectic. Like, I had things like Kate Bush, Wuthering Heights, because it was in my key, and I used to do, like, operatic arias and then a bit of Ella Fitzgeraldy stuff. I was at Melbourne Uni and I was studying music and, you know, I think more than I wanted the money, obviously, but I think more than anything, I wanted to perform. And so I did it on the street. I would have done it anywhere.
Well, on that, though, you spent 2 years not performing because of COVID.
Yeah.
How nervous was it to get back into it?
Look, the overriding feeling that I had coming back, I'm doing 9 to 5, the musical at the moment, written by Dolly Parton, which is just a gas, really fun. But my overriding feeling, I think, on opening night was just I was so grateful to be back doing what I was meant to do. I think when it was taken away from us all for over 2 years, we all realised how much we miss it. The audience missed it, but, boy, us performers really miss it as well.
Yeah. We cannot wait to see you in Mary Poppins. For all ticketing info, fly over to our website. Would you please thank Marina Prior?